Currently, I am quite near the end, so I thought there was still a bit to go because I read that there was 9 chapters. But apparently we're quite near the end, so let's see if we can finish this game. If not in 1 part, in 2 parts. So, here we are. Manix. So, in the cutscene at the end of the part last night, Manix showed up at prison to kill Link. And Paxton has finally realised that killing Link would not be a good idea. So he's going to find stuff. First of all, I have to figure out how to get to the next tier. That's great. That's really helpful. What? Now I can't see what he was focusing on. Alright, so we're going through the door, I take it. But we need to watch out for the janitor. The reason that I know we're near the end, I started watching Matt and Pat's playthrough of this from when they did Two Best Friends Play, because, like I said, in like part one or whatever, I never watched their playthrough because I wanted to play the game myself one day. And I mean, it's taken bloody years until we got to that point, but are they having a staring contest, or they're just standing staring at each other? I'm taking it they're gonna talk. There we go.
We can talk in here. Where's Lucy? What are you doing with my daughter?
Calm down. I need you to take me to Lincoln Burrows.
But where's Lucy? How do I know she's safe? Who are you people?
Just take me to Burrows and everything will be okay.
I don't want anything to happen.
Shut it! Your child is in a safe place. The best way to help her is to do as you're told. Somebody's coming. Let's go.
I need you to take me to Lincoln Burrows. Half of the morning to you, lad. He sounds like Primly Walsh.
Bastard.
What was I saying? Aye. So, So I finally got to watch their playthrough. And it was good to see that the bit from last part where we were doing some nighttime stealth when Paxton was going to try and destroy his records. Pat also failed on that like a million times and was getting really frustrated. So it's good to know it's not just me that couldn't do that. But when they got to that point, like, I was surprised because that was in their final part and they only had 30 minutes left of the video. So I'm like, if we really only get 30 minutes left, but I guess we'll find out. I feel like we're not, like, close enough to the end for that. Oh fuck. But maybe we are. I'm gonna have to wait for him to move again. Just admire the, boxes. I mean, look, they've even put the effort to put the wee fragile symbol on the boxes. You know, the art team deserve appreciation for this game. Where did he go? The art team are the only people who deserve appreciation for this game. Shit. He's gonna walk in a square. If I can get out the bloody door. Walk in a square. Someone in here. No, he's gonna hear me. Oh. That's wait. Oh, that's the I'm at the other end. Fuck. so Matt and Pat suck at this game as much, well, Pat was playing, suck at this game as much as I do, and that does make me feel slightly better. I mean, they suck at a lot of games, but Pat plays Dark Souls, and he couldn't get through this stupid game, so I'm gonna take that as a win on my part. I don't actually know what difficulty they were playing it on. I'm pretty sure from the little bit I did watch back when it came out, they were playing it on the middle difficulty. At this rate, we are going to have more than half an hour left, because it's going to take me half an hour to get through this goddamn door. They also pointed out that for a game called Prison Break, they spend a lot of time breaking into the prison. It's like, yeah, this guy spends a lot of time breaking into various rooms in the prison. I am, though, genuinely interested at this point to find out what Mannix is up to be quite honest. Like, I'm intrigued to know. Now, do I need to hide behind here? Is that what I'm meant to be doing? Is he going to go away again if I hide? Comes over this way and he looks at the door, so if I'm there he will see me. So maybe I just need to be really quick. Say there is, that's not gonna happen. A very serious event on screen here. Yeah, I am curious to see. I mean, it's not as if the game's gonna end with like Link and getting killed or whatever, because we know that they all escape the prison. But I'm intrigued to see what happens to Mannix. I mean, ultimately he's gonna lose, but you know. I'm intrigued to see how it plays out. Our stereotypically Irish friend. And we're on the goddamn sewers again. Like, remember the sewers in Arkham Asylum? There's one that I didn't mention when I was talking about gamers with sewer sections. The sewer in Arkham Asylum with the bloody Killer Croc mission. Which actually didn't bother me that much, because Killer Croc doesn't scare me because I love crocodiles.
I'm not asking for the cure for cancer, Brad. This fighting has got to stop.
I'll find out who's behind this, sir. I promise.
I don't want promises, I want answers.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, like I love crocodiles and all of alligators, so Killer Croc.
What are you looking at, morons? Clean this mess up!
Right away, sir.
You need me? I'll be in the break room.
But a lot of stuff in Arkham Asylum.
How long you think before Pope figures out Bellic is behind all this?
The smart money says 2 weeks, if not sooner.
Like, Arkham Asylum gave me genuine trauma, not gonna lie. Like, I had nightmares for 2 weeks when I played Arkham Asylum, and I know that sounds pathetic, but I just have a real issue with that game. It just gave me problems. I've talked before about how Arkham Asylum was a bad collection of mental health, but it really did give me fear. I have this real fear of old asylums, and I mean, it's not an irrational fear considering they are terrifying. But obviously, like, they don't really exist anymore. But any game that involves some kind of asylum or sanatorium or something gives me the absolute fear. It bothers me as well, because obviously I'm someone with mental health issues, and I'm like, if I lived in a different time, then I would probably end up in one of those places. And that. Can that guy not see me? Is there something in front of me, or is he just... No, but for some reason can see me. Yeah, like... if I lived in a different time, like, I could end up in a... one of those terrifying asylums, like Arkham, and I'm just like, that gives me... so much anxiety, ironically. So I hate anything that involves asylums, just really makes me feel, like, genuinely ill, because I always just think, like, it's just a bit... it's just the idea that it could have been me. Or anyone else that has mental health issues that absolutely did not deserve to be in one of those places. So Arkham, that's the thing, it's like it wasn't even like the enemies, it wasn't like Joker, it wasn't the Batman villains, it was just the actual like Arkham itself that gave me issues. The rest of the Arkham series didn't have that issue, but Arkham itself really messed me up.
Here.
I love how I'm picking a lot right in front of that security camera and it doesn't seem to get alert Link. Ooh, I get to go and talk to Link. You notice that like
the game's about to start. You coming?
Yeah, be right there. I just have to let Burrows know he's being moved.
Okay, I'll wait for you.
As much as they manage to get the actors and use their faces and their voices and stuff, the actual characters in the game don't have a lot of lines.
Burrows!
Yeah?
Escort's coming to take you to the infirmary.
Hey, Smith, the game's on. You coming or not?
I'm coming!
I feel like Bellix had more lines than, like, the main character. Not the Bellix, not the main character, but, like, you know, the characters people actually like Mike and Link. Instead we just have a lot of Bellic and Link gets like 3 lines of time.
I've waited all season for this rematch.
This is Warden Pope. Captain Bellic has gone AWOL. Is he there in the shoe?
No, sir. Haven't seen him all day. Wait, I'll ask Smith. Hey, Smith. You seen Brad around?
Nope.
No, sir. He's not here.
Okay, thanks. If you see him, please tell him to report to my office immediately.
Bellix in trouble. Where do I go? Oh, sorry, I'm not
your prayers, Burrows.
Forget it, Maddox.
I was gonna do Burrows first, but I'm flexible.
See what you got.
All right, Burrows. Stand clear of the door. We're taking you to the infirmary.
This isn't over, Paxton. Count on it.
Chapter 9, so we are pretty much in the end game now. Alright. Paxton got the all-clear message from Aldo saying his company records have been destroyed. Mannix arrived in the prison disguised as a convict. His mission killed both Burroughs and Paxton. Paxton interrupted him just as he was breaking into Burroughs' cell. So we're at the end. All that's left to do now is break out, I guess.
Sorry, no room on the bus, pal.
Give it up, Paxton. You can't win. I have all the cards. Don't give up, do you, Paxton?
Why'd you set me up?
You knew too much. Knew about my days with the mob. You became a liability.
That was
Just get in the way! I don't have time for this!
It was never about Lincoln or even national security, was it, Maddox? The whole frame-up was just a trick to get Aldo out of hiding so you could protect the company!
Aldo Burrows is a traitor! Must be stopped!
Good luck with that. How's it working for you so far?
You're gonna die now, Paxton! How's that working for you?
Thank you.
Was that the end? Oh, it does it! Wow, look at that. Wasn't maybe the most climactic ending I've ever seen, but we did it. Yeah. I don't know, I expected Escape in the Present to be a bit more. Here we are, trophy collection. So we've got all of these lovely story trophies, of which there are many. So we've got complete chapter 1 without getting spotted is one that we need to get. Beat your first... Yeah, where do you do the underground fights? Defeat 50 enemies in underground fights. When do you... Get tattoos for all 6 locations in your body. Wait, what are these? Okay, I can do that one. Beat up more than 100 people, win a match. Yeah, exactly. We're earn 5,000. Yeah, like. Complete every chapter without being seen. Well, that's not gonna bloody happen, is it? 50 reversal moves in fights. Win a fight using only reversal moves and finishing moves. Right, I'm gonna Google while we're here. Underground fights. Prison break. PS3. Where are they? I'm in chapter 2 and I don't think I've seen them. During chapter 7 is the best time. At some point you'll be introduced to the king for the second time. It seems that you need to earn $1,000 to earn a secure place in the cell that contains... Yeah, we've done that. Oh, it says the fight will take place in the underground arena. Once you've beaten Bellic, you'll be instructed to complete some other meaningless tasks. Instead, backtrack to the main yard and you'll find King and his posse standing by one of the buildings. You can talk to him to arrange a fight or if you wish, purchase some tattoos. Oh, so if you go back to chapter 7 and then after you beat Bellic, you can do more underground fights. Someone else says you can do these in chapter 1. As soon as you get back from stealing the meds, the qualification for getting into the fights, you can walk up to the king and start the underground fights right here. There is a patch of game towards the middle before chapter 7 where you aren't in the yard for a while, so you can't do these. You can't do them at the beginning of chapter 7 either. You have to win the $500, go and retrieve it, and then hand it over to the officer. So, okay, so like, they're saying... Basically, you could do it anytime you were in the yard. I just didn't know. Because, how was I meant to know that? I've got literally no idea. Okay, so what I'll do is we'll go back into the game. And we'll have a wee look-see at, see if I can get to the underground fights. And we'll have a look at what that's got.
Something you want?
Oh, look! I found it! I found it!
You got the green, I got the ink.
Okay, so... Why can't I scroll? Okay, so the tattoos are all
You want to fight? Come with me. That was an old school whipping.
I forgot because I already made $500 during the game. I'm so stupid. Anyway, let's get started.
Looking for a tat.
And then I'm gonna put
let's do it.
So can I get these? Oh right, yeah, I can get them in different parts of my body. So let's get that there. Okay, so Oh, I love jogging. Ooh. Oh, I like that. Okay. Let's see. Oh, look, you can get warts out of that. USA. Another dragon. I kind of love that. Yeah, let's get that. It's 400. Okay. I'm glad I got all the money now because I need the money to get all these tattoos. And then a back tattoo. So I need one that's not going to go on the dragon. That one's quite nice. Ooh, that's nice. This is giving me bad punchy vibes. I like that, but it kind of goes too near the dragon. Where is it? Yeah, I like this one. That one there, but it's where the... I never actually checked to see if there was a claw from here, so... Oh, I got the thing, what do you call it? There wasn't actually that many from here. That's just the best part. Maybe get the one that says dead. Sweet! Look at them! Oh man, look! They look so cool! Okay, well, that's me finally finished with this game. Thank you so much for watching. I'll try and edit this down into something more fun because I realised I just spent a lot of time punching that one guy in the face and telling a story about a teacher. Thank you for watching. I don't know what my next Let's Play is going to be yet, but I'm sure it'll be fun. So thanks for coming along, enduring this nightmare of a game, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!